Today I'm going to go over how to connect these types of MIDI controllers to VCV Rack and show a few of my favorite ways to use them in my patches.
I've got two different styles of MIDI controllers here, the Korg Nano Control 2 and the Novation Launchpad Mini Mark 3. The Nano Control has faders, buttons, and these knobs that can all be mapped to different CC values in VCV Rack. And the Novation Launchpad Mini has these drum pad style buttons on it. And usually this page would have a drum rack layout on it, and this page would have a keyboard layout on it that would both be set up to output pitch information. But I've got them both set up to have these MIDI CC faders on them, and I'll show you how I set that up because that's what we'll need to use this to control VCV Rack. Okay, I won't go too in-depth into this because it's not a video on the Launchpad Mini specifically, but you will need to know this if you're going to use it with VCV Rack. So you'll want to open up Novation Components and select the device you're going to be adding your MIDI CC faders to. You'd want to hit New Custom Mode, and then here we are. Now over here, this is where we could add something like a drum grid that will output notes, but we don't want notes. We want MIDI CCs. There are a few things that we could add to our custom page that control MIDI CC values. We have a vertical unipolar and bipolar fader, and we have a horizontal unipolar and bipolar fader, and a MIDI CC button that works kind of like a gate or a trigger. You just grab the one you want and drag it over. It's a very visual editor. And then you have to choose a MIDI CC number, and I believe MIDI CCs go from 1 to 127. I chose between 30 and 45 for the faders that I added to my Launchpad Mini because I knew that those weren't numbers that my Korg Nano controller were using, and I wanted to be able to use both of them interchangeably without them controlling the same parameters. And then we have to choose a MIDI channel, and I choose global channel because I just find that's the best way not to run into any issues. If you choose channel 5 and you can't remember which channel you were outputting it on, you may run into some frustration, so I just do that. You can go ahead and add more. This would be a bipolar fader. You can change the color, change the CC number, change the channel. And then we have the MIDI CC button, which gives us the option to choose between momentary, toggle, and trigger for the button. Momentary is like a gate that stays high for as long as you're holding the button down. Toggle will stay high once you push the button until you push the button again to release it. And trigger will just be a trigger. I chose momentary. You can choose your number again, whatever you want. On value being 127, that's what we want. That is the highest value. Off value, 0. And then global channel again. I will not save this page because I already have my pages set up. But I will show you with one of those. What you would do is hit Send to Launchpad and choose a page. And now it's on your Launchpad. And I would recommend saving all of your pages because if you overwrite one that you didn't mean to overwrite, it makes it much easier to send that page back to where you wanted it to be without having to recreate that page. Now that we've got the MIDI controllers set up, I want to show you how I connect them to VCV Rack using these two modules. MIDI CC to CV and MIDI Map both connect to MIDI controllers that output MIDI CC information. And the first step with both of them is to connect a device. So for this one, I'm going to connect the Launchpad Mini Mark 3. And for MIDI Map, I'm going to connect the Korg Nano controller. The difference between these two modules is how they use that MIDI CC information to control VCV Rack. MIDI CC to CV has a grid of numbers where you can input the CC values you'd like to use. And you can edit those CC values by clicking on them and typing in the number you would like to use. Or you can click on it and hit a button on your MIDI controller, and it will automatically update it with the CC value for that button, which is handy if you don't know what MIDI CC values you're working with. And this grid of MIDI CC values corresponds with this grid of outputs. So this first output is connected to MIDI CC 30. And for me, I know that's my first fader over here. Right now, there's no frequency modulation happening because the value is all the way at the bottom and we set the value to be from 0 to 127. So right now, with the value being 0, it's doing nothing. But if we turn it all the way up, we get a lot of frequency modulation, or we can do somewhere in the middle. So that's why I like using faders. And then on this last page here, I have a grid that I've set up that has all of the MIDI CC numbers, but they're gates. And the reason that I did that is for modules like this, where you can have a trigger input. So now if I hit that button just once, it'll trigger this envelope. Some things just don't work as well with a fader. So I like having that option, but they're the same MIDI CC value. So whether I do the trigger or the fader, they are using the same value. The MIDI map module is a little bit different because it's not outputting control voltage. It's just controlling one parameter with one CC value. So the way you use it is you click in this space here and now it says mapping and you move something and now it understands that that's CC zero. And if I click on this LFO, there's a little yellow square there that's showing me that something is connected. And really important, don't click on anything else if you don't want to map anything else. Click away. Because you can map several things to the same parameter. But now, because the fader is all the way down, the LFO is all the way down. And if I move it up, I can change the speed of that LFO very quickly. And so it's just two different ways of working. Last time we used the CV output to control the frequency modulation input for the LFO to speed up the LFO. And this time we're directly mapping a parameter so that we can physically turn the knob and speed up the LFO and slow it down. I like using both of these modules in my patches because depending on the workflow, sometimes it's nice just to map a parameter and sometimes it's nice to have the flexibility of the CV output. I especially like mapping a parameter when something doesn't have a CV input, like these buttons for the Deja Vu for T and X on marbles. They don't have any way of controlling them to turn them on and off besides going in and clicking them. But if I were to push a button on my controller, and you always push the button so that it brings up the CC value and then click. And then you push another button and then click. Click away. And now when I push these buttons, they will turn those Deja Vu buttons on and off. To unmap these parameters, you just right click on them and they unmap. Now that we've talked about how each of these modules work, I want to show you how I like to use them in a patch. And the first thing, making sure I click into this mapping area, move the fader I want to use. The first thing I like to do is map these faders to the outputs on my mixer so I can very quickly adjust the volumes. And then these little M's are actually for mute because this is supposed to be a mixing MIDI controller. And so I'll just go ahead and map those to all the mutes on here. I like to use something that I think I'll remember. And then for these knobs up here, I'm going to connect those to the sends. Oop. I ended up clicking where there is no parameter. So now I'm not mapping anymore. So I'll go back, make sure we're mapping. Move the knob I want to use, even though I know it says CC18 and that's CC18. Click, move the next knob. There. Now I'll be able to easily switch between one send and the other. I click off for now. That'll be T. That'll be X. Be able to turn those on if I want to. And I really like mapping these parameters, even though they have control voltage inputs. Because, well, rate I don't think I'll map, but the spread knob and the steps knob and jitter, they have such a large amount of control in how the patch works. And so I would prefer to map those if I can over just adding control voltage. So I'm going to turn this knob, spread, this knob will be jitter. And my last two knobs I'm going to set up to be these filter cutoffs. And then these four last faders, I'll connect to the ADSR. And for this module, I think I will actually use these first two to control the FM amount of the LFO and maybe the signal input for the nano arc. So now if I turn up the volume on our Platts track here, I can add a delay, switch to the other delay. Change the cutoff on the filter. Move the ADSR around. If I map this LFO to the cutoff of one of the filters, maybe the high one. Now I can go ahead and increase the speed of that LFO, and it will increase the speed of that cutoff changing. But it's all very playable. It's very momentary. Or I could use that for a whole section of the track. If instead of using the pitch information from here, I decided to take my pitch from marbles. Change the jitter and the spread. Deja vu I didn't map. That would have been a nice one to map. Another thing I like to do is put a VCA in the way and then use one of these outputs to determine the amount of the VCA. So if you want to keep it to a really low range of notes, my understanding that that will work, especially if you bring this down a little bit. Or you can go up and add more higher pitch notes. I hope that gave you an idea of how these techniques can help you have more hands-on control in your patches. It's something I'm going to be exploring more, and I hope you have fun with it. I'll see you in the next one. Bye!